So it looks like the suspect went inside that parking structure and was able to go in, maneuver around, and come back out. We do know CHP has got approval for the pit maneuver, and if you see him accelerate and get next to the vehicle, here it comes. Well, he was really thinking about it. He's thinking about cross traffic. He's thinking about the suspect increasing his speed. Here it goes. He's going to tap the end of that, back into that truck. Probably looking at what's ahead. Want to make sure when he does it, very nice, very nice. But not quite enough to get the vehicle completely spin and then get another car wedged in front of him. Now, doing that and not getting it done the first time could make the suspect drive at a higher rate of speed. Trying it again, a little better. Perfect. Nobody on the shoulder. Another patrol car runs up towards the front of the vehicle, stops it from being able to continue on. And right now what you're going to do is have a standoff. Now, these things get dicey right here. They don't know if the suspect's armed. We're on San Vicente Boulevard at Highland Avenue. Suspect not getting out of the vehicle at this point. You can see two patrol cars in front of them. Their doors open. Their guns drawn. They're not certain exactly what they're dealing with here. All we know that the suspect was really wanted for was impeding traffic in the carpool lane in South L.A., meaning driving well below the speed limit and slowing traffic. At this point, we'll see if the suspect does decide to give himself up, but right now that does not appear the case. He may have just thrown something out of the window. It's hard to say exactly what just happened there, but officers have a standoff now here on San Vicente Boulevard. As far as traffic is concerned, there's a pretty good detour around this. You see the suspect reaching over now, grabbing that towel, that sheet, whatever that was. We can sort of see inside the cabin. The real concern in a situation like this is, does that suspect have a weapon? And these things get very touchy. He lit up a cigarette, seems to be content to just sit back and relax and see how this is going to play out. Authorities, the officers here, they just do not know if he could possibly have a weapon inside that vehicle. And that's why you're seeing the standoff. And it gets touchy if the suspect does do something like reach for a weapon or come out of that vehicle and point something at officers. That could be tough. Now, the suspect is trying to back up, and the other patrol car did not block him. A little interesting why they didn't take that opportunity to put a patrol car behind him and then just get out of that patrol car. So now it appears, even though we had this stopped, we're once again traveling on San Vicente Boulevard in pursuit mode. So it looked like we were going to have a standoff, and the suspect was able to back up, turn around, and continue on. And Jay Eckstein is with me, always helping me down there. It looks like to him the front right is wobbling a little bit. I sort of see that as well. And that could have happened when the vehicle slipped sideways when they did the pit maneuver. A lot of pressure on that tire and on that rim. It looks like they're going to do the pit maneuver again here. There you go. Here goes. And once again, not quite hard enough, but you do see that right front wheel. It does look a little off. And now it looks like they're going to wedge him in. So we're going to try and get to the other side here so that we can get a better look. But it looks like they've taken the opportunity now to wedge him in. And by I don't believe he'll be able to continue on in this pursuit. I have to come around and get over here. Just make a left turn. You're clear right here. I need to go that way. I see him, but... Jay told us the guy made a run for it. Oh, the vehicle overturned. So we lost him behind the tree there for a moment, and it looked like that doing that pit maneuver, it was enough to make the vehicle overturn. The suspect is still inside the vehicle. Now they're going to have to get him medical attention. I don't see an ambulance here quite yet. It looks like they're breaking the window open so they can at least see if he has a weapon and if they can get him out of the vehicle. So they have drug him out of the vehicle now on San Vicente Boulevard at Redondo Boulevard. They're trying to get the suspect into custody here. They'll try and get him face down. They'll get cuffs on him and take him into custody. Unclear if he was injured in the accident when that vehicle overturned, but you could tell sometimes it could be extremely difficult to try and get someone into custody, taking four officers there to pin him down and get his hands behind his back. You know, fortunately, no one was injured that we know of in this incident. They did the third pit maneuver, if you will. The second one was somewhat effective. The first one, not at all. The third one was effective in as much as it flipped the vehicle over. And the suspect now is in custody. So San Vicente is going to be shut down here at Redondo for some time, at least for westbound travel. Eastbound travel is going to be fine. It appears the suspect is okay right now. They're frisking him, make sure he doesn't have a weapon. Doesn't appear to be injured in that crash. Standing up, and it looks like they're going to take him to a patrol car and take the suspect into custody here. This is all over without incident. So no one was injured. San Vicente westbound once again at Redondo will be shut down for a while. Eastbound travel is open. And fortunately, even though that vehicle overturned, it didn't hit another car. And we don't believe that anyone was injured. So it's all over here with the suspect in custody. Copy that.
Hello, I'm Mark Brown. Get more great ABC7 content by clicking the subscribe button for our YouTube channel and download the ABC7 Los Angeles streaming app on Fire TV, Android TV, Apple TV, and Roku to watch on your TV.